Hello everyone, today I shall be discussing health indicators. So why you need health indicators? So when you have to answer how healthy is the given community, you require some indicators to measure the health. Although we cannot measure health, but we can predict or we can come to some opinion with the help of the following indicators. Indicators are not allowed only to measure the health status of a community, but also to compare the health status of one country with another country. For assessment of healthcare needs, when you have to allocate resources and you have scarcity of resources, you require indicators so that on the basis of indicators you can allocate funds. For monitoring and evaluation of health services which you are providing, the health activities and the various national health programs which are running at present, indicators help to measure the extent to which the objectives and targets of a program are being attained. So what you call health indicator or health index? It has been suggested that in relation to health trends, the term indicator is to be preferred, whereas health index is generally considered to be a result of combining health indicators. So what an indicator should have? Indicator should be valid, means should measure but supposed to be measure. Indicator should be reliable. Answer should be same if measured by different people in same situation at different places. Should be sensitive to changes in the situation concerned. Should be specific, they should reflect changes only in the situation concerned. Should be feasible, they should have the ability to obtain data needed. And should be relevant, should contribute to the understanding of the phenomena of interest. So, let's answer this question. Can we measure health? No. No single indicator can measure the health. So, we use multiple indicators to reach some consensus. So, we use different type of indicators like mortality indicators, morbidity indicators, disability rates, nutritional status indicators, healthcare delivery indicators, utilization rates, indicators of social and mental health, environmental indicators, socioeconomic indicators, health policy indicators, indicators of quality of life, and there are many other indicators. So you can see there are multiple indicators here mentioned. We use different type of indicators for different purposes. So let's have a look about mortality indicators. So there are plenty of mortality indicators, but we will talk here only the few, because the rest of the indicators will be covered in epidemiology and other various chapters. So what is crude death rate? So in simple words, it is defined as the number of deaths per 1000 population per year in a community. So what is expectation of life? It is the average number of years that will be lived by those who born alive into a population if the current age specific mortality rates persist. Means when a person get birth, so how many years at current situation he will live. Next one is the age specific death rates. These are defined as the total number of deaths occurring in a specific age group of the population in a defined area during a specific period per 1000 estimated total population of the same age group. So if we have to find out round about how many deaths are occurring between 15 years to 24 years, so we use age specific death rates. Infant mortality rate. It is a ratio of deaths under 1 year of age in a given year to the total number of live births in the same year, and if you have to express in rate, then we use number of deaths per 1000 live births. Means 1000 live births if take place, then how many dies before the first birthday. Child death rate, this is number of deaths at ages 1 to 4 years in a given year per 1000 children in the age group at the midpoint of the year concerned. For example, if you calculating the child death rate of 2018, then we will see number of deaths which occurred from 1 to 4 years of age per 1000 children and the total population of 1 to 4 years at 1st July of 2018. Under 5 proportion mortality rate, this is the proportional of the total deaths occurring in the under 5 age group. Means if there are 100 deaths total including adults, then out of 100, how many are less than 5 years? Adult mortality rates, probability of dying between the age of 15 and 60 years per 1000 populations. This is the deaths between 15 to 60 years per 1000 population. And what is maternal mortality rate? This is the number of maternal deaths per 1 lakh live births. Then we have disease specific mortality rates. For example, if there are 100 deaths in 1 month, then if you have to find out how many are deaths due to the cardiovascular diseases out of these 100, then this will be the disease specific mortality rates. Proportional mortality rate means if there is a total number of deaths, how much proportion is contributed by the some specific disease or specific age or specific gender or specific female. For example, if you calculate all deaths all over the world, you can say now that 71% of the total deaths are due to the non-communicable diseases. Then the case fatality rates. This measures the risk of person dying from a certain disease within a given time period. For example, some person is having a disease. Then what is the case fatality means? What are the chances of his dying from that disease? Some diseases have 100% case fatality rate. Like what? Can you give me an example? Rabies. So rabies has a 100% case fatality rates. Then years of potential life lost, YPLL. Years of potential life lost through premature death. Means you were supposed to be died, for example, at 75 years, okay, and you died at 30 years. So you lost 45 years of potential life. Mortality indicators do not reveal the burden of ill health in the community, so we require the morbidity indicators for supplementation of health status. So we use incidence and prevalence. These will be discussed more in epidemiology. Although in simple words, incidence is the number of new cases and the prevalence is the total number of cases including new and old. Then we have notification rates, different notifications from different type of diseases from hospitals. Then we have attendance rates, what are the OPD attendance rates, what are the specific OPD attendance rates, what are the IPD attendance rates. We have admissions, readmission, discharges and duration of stay in the hospitals, and how many times you get sick and how many times you are absent from work or school due to illness. These all are morbidity indicators. Then we have other indicators, those are disability rates. Usually we divide these in two groups. One is the event type indicators, which includes number of days of restricted activity, bed disability days, and work loss days within a specific period. The next type of category is the person type indicators, where have limitation of mobility and the limitation of activity. So these indicators gives us the disability rates. So other disability indicators which are important to us, one is the HALE, that is health adjusted life expectancy. It was earlier known as disability adjusted life expectancy. It is based on life expectancy at birth, but includes an adjustment for time spent in poor health. It means as the equivalent number of years in full health that a newborn can expect to live based on current rates of ill health and mortality. Then another one comes is the quality adjusted life years, QALY. It is based on number of years of life that would be added by intervention. Each year of perfect health is assigned a value of 1 down to value of 0. For death, 0, and for a perfect health value is given 1. For example, 1 QALY is equal to 1 year of life into 1 utility value, that is equal to 1 QALY is year of life lived in perfect health. Once 1 QALY is equal to 1 year of life in perfect health. Half a year lived in perfect health is equivalent to 0.5 QALY, that means 1 year into 0.5 utility value. So another one is the disability free life expectancy. So you can, other words, you can say it is the active life is the average number of years an individual is expected to live free of disability is current pattern of morbidity and disability continue to apply. So another we have DALY, that is disability adjusted life years. It's a measure of overall disease burden expressed as a number of years lost due to ill health or disability or early death. So it combines years of lost lives, means calculated from the number of deaths at each age multiplied by the expected remaining years of life according to global standard life expectancy. Years of lost disability, YLD, where the number of incident cases due to injury and illness is multiplied by the average duration of the disease and a weighting factor reflecting the severity of the disease on a scale from 0 perfect health to 1 dead. So DALY is calculated by the formula years of lost life plus years lost to disability, that is equal to DALY. Then we have nutritional status indicators. Usually we use incidence of low birth weight and weight and height standards for children up to 5 of years under nutritional status indicators. When you have to measure the healthcare delivery, then we use healthcare delivery indicators, and for this we use doctor to population ratio, means how many doctors are there for a specific population, doctor to nurse ratio, population to bed ratio, population per health subcenter, how much population is being covered by one health subcenter, population per trained birth attendants. So for healthcare delivery, we frequently use these indicators. Then comes the utilization rates. What services you are providing, how often or how they are utilized, we require utilization rates. So utilization of services or actual coverage is expressed as the proportion of people in need of service who actually receive it in given period, usually a year. It is affected by factors such as availability and accessibility of health services and the attitude of an individual towards his health and the healthcare system. A few examples of utilization rates are cited below. Proportion of infants who are fully immunized, proportion of pregnant women who receive antenatal care, percentage of population using the various methods of family planning, bed occupancy rate, average length of stay in the hospital, and the bed turnover ratio. So, few indicators for your social and mental health. So, this includes the suicides, homicide, other acts of violence and other crimes, the road traffic accidents, juvenile delinquency, alcohol, drug abuse, smoking, consumptions of tranquilizers, obesity, etc. So these figures, these numbers give us the social and mental health of a community. So we have another here, the battered baby and battered wife syndromes. So what is battered baby? So when you blow someone or have physical injury to the babies or the ladies in domestic violence, so they are called the battered baby or battered wife. So to measure the environment, we have few environmental indicators. So environmental indicators, they reflect the quality of physical and biological environment. They include indicators relating to pollution of air and water radiation, solid waste, noise exposure to toxic substances in food and drink, etc. So the proportion of population having access to safe water and sanitary facilities, etc., also comes under the environmental indicators. So we have the socio-economic indicators. So these include at which rate the population of a community is increasing, the per capita GNP, that is gross national product, level of unemployment in a community, dependency ratio, literacy rates, especially the female literacy rates, and the family size, housing, number of persons per room, and the per capita calorie availability for a family or for a person. Then we have the health policy indicators. Proportion of gross national product is spent on health services. Proportion of GNP spent on health related activities. Proportion of total health resources devoted to primary health care. So few indicators we have for quality of life. Those are physical quality of life index, that is PQLLI. It measures infant mortality, life expectancy at age 1, and literacy. And it is scaled to 0 to 100. Another one is Human Developmental Index, HDI, that is life expectancy at birth, ability to acquire knowledge, that is means year of schooling, and per capita income. Social indicators. So as per the United Nations, they are divided into 12 categories, which include population, family formation, families and households, learning and educational services, earning activities, distribution of income, consumption and accumulation, social security, welfare services, health services, nutrition, housing, environment, public order, safety, time, leisure and culture, social stratification, and mobility. Then we have few the basic need indicators. Those include calorie consumption, access to water, life expectancy, deaths due to diseases, illiteracy, doctors and nurses populations, rooms per person, and GNP per capita. Then we have few special indicators. The first one is the health for all indicators. So WHO, the World Health Organization, gave few goals which was supposed to be achieved by 2080. which included health policy indicators, social and economic indicators, indicators for provision for healthcare, and health status indicators. In 2000, after the review of these health for all indicators, WHO came up with the Millennium Development Goals, which were adopted in 2000 and to be achieved by 2015. So here are the few only which discussed here, which were related to health. The goal 1 was eradicate extreme poverty and hunger. The goal 4th was reduce child mortality. Goal 5 was improve maternal health. Goal 6 was to combat HIV and AIDS, malaria and other diseases. Goal 7 was ensure environmental sustainability. And goal 8, develop a global partnership for development and research. So in 2015, when these goals were reviewed, and WHO came to know the maximum number of the countries has not achieved these goals, they came up with sustainable development goals, which was to be achieved by 2030, and they are 17 goals and 169 targets. And goal 3 in SDG is exclusively for health, and about SDGs we will discuss later on in brief. So 4th one is the global reference list of core health indicators 2018. The global reference list is standard set of 1000 core indicators prioritized in 4 domains, and these are: number 1 is the health status indicators, which include mortality by age and sex, mortality by cause, fertility, morbidity. And the second one is the risk factor indicators, which include nutrition, infection, environmental risk factors, non-communicable diseases, injury, harmful traditional practices. The third one is the service coverage indicators, which include reproductive, maternal, newborn, child and adolescent health, immunization, HIV, HIV and TB collaborations, tuberculosis, malaria, neglected tropical diseases, screening and preventive care, maternal health, substance abuse and essential health services. And the fourth subheading of special indicators is health system indicators, which include quality and safety of care, access to health care, health workforce, health information, health financing, health security and governance. The fifth one is the health index of India, and that is Niti Aayog. So Niti Aayog, you all know, have divided states and UTs in 3 categories: the larger states 20, smaller states 8, and UT 9. The health index is weighted composite index, which includes 3 basic indicators. One is health outcomes, 70% contribution, governance and information 12%, key inputs and process 18%. So now the Niti Aayog, based on these 3, health outcomes, governance and information, and key input and processes, they are ranking the states and union territories, and they are giving the health index. So this all about the lecture today, the health indicators. You can see that we use different type of indicators for different type of health related measurements, but no indicator fulfills all the 6 qualities which we discussed. So we require different type of indicators for different type of purpose, and to express health, which you can see is very difficult to measure, we require specific indicators for specific type of measurements. Thanks for listening, and if you like to have or go through more lectures on community medicines, you can subscribe to our channel, that is www.youtube.com/c/healthandfamily, and frequently we keep on updating the new lectures which will help you to clear your doubts or gain extra knowledge for your competitive examinations. Thank you.